business.
And also developer. What is the developer that we are teaching here? How many concepts of development we teach our students? What is the model of development that we have? The only model of development that we have is the Western model. What is it by developing? Developing means try to be an American in another 50 years or maybe 40 years or 20 years in an accelerated program. Development is Western development, science is Western science, and Buddhism, single life. So we are trying to compare these. We are trying to patch up. What happens is that we try to patch up. We have science. We want to keep that. Because if you don't keep that with us, then we will be named or termed pariahs. Pariahs are using resources. Now, because of that, we will say, well, this is common. This is common to science. This is common to Buddhism. This is common to this and that. But whereas, we don't go deep into the foundation of science and foundation of religion. Without going deeply into this foundation, we try to compare very superficial. I don't know what Dr. Narayan has to say on meditation. I am not here at that time. So in a way, I suppose it's not there by me to comment on what is supposed to have been said. But I guess you find my view on this. Meditation as practiced in West is nothing but meditation to exploit the society far more efficiently the next week. That is, you try to release your energy and release the tensions, stresses, so that you will be free to do what you have been doing all these years, next year, next year. Now, is that the meditation that was, well, even the word meditation, I don't agree. Is that the bhavana that Buddha wanted us to practice? Now, let me briefly, I don't have much time, let me briefly give a description on how this science was created in the West. This happened 500 years ago, 500 years ago. Of course, Galileo came to home now. But the super renaissance in the 15th century started with people like Leonardo da Vinci, Michelangelo, pronounced as Michelangelo by the English, but his Latin or Italian name is Michelangelo. They are the first people who try to break away from the Catholic Chintani. From the Catholic Chintani and create a new Chintani. By giving prominence to the individual over the society. Now, what is Chintana? Chintana is really the concept that we have created. It describes the process and also, well, I put it this way. Chintana is a thread that binds all the human, all those things that have been created by the human being in a particular culture. Whether it's art, whether it's science, whether it's dancing, music, whatever it is, or even cooking, or even the way we dress. I wouldn't call it a worldview, but Chintana is a thread that binds all these things together. The Chintana of the medieval era, before Leonardo da Vinci and Michelangelo came to the scene, was Catholic. Catholic is Buddhist. Catholicism means Buddhism. The Buddhistic chintane that they had was broken by the renouncement. The individual was given prominence over society. The Catholic Church had to give away finally to some kind of Protestantism. Of course, it took some time. You had to wait till Martin Luther came in the 1517 and put up the first post. I suppose he was the first person to put up a post. I am calling the father of Martin Luther. Well, I am not like that. Things are like that, but then just trying to be, well, taking these things very lightly and so on. Please don't misunderstand. Now, after Luther, and of course after Galileo, Galileo came about 25 years after this poster program, then what happened was, the world, which was taken into consideration as one entity, wholeness, was broken up and it was studied in branches of, patterns of, whatever that should be called. In fact, one of the things that Galileo did was to break up the motion of projectile into two parts, the horizontal part and the vertical part. That's the first thing that he did. And that's something that we teach our illustration even today. Break the motion into two parts. Break it up into parts. That's, I would call, modern Christian Jewish teaching. Of course, there are various other things that have been added. Abstract thinking, Aristotle's logic, then attitude towards the world, something that Professor Kathir is going to mention. The objective world, that is the world. To be manipulated, and you can manipulate it, and the world behaves according to certain rules. These rules can be found out, the objective, these things were, they are from the divinity. Newton developed on these things, and of course, within the Chintanya, there was certain paradigms in the sense of Thomas Kuhn. There was the paradigm of Newton, or Newtonian paradigm, which was replaced by thermodynamic paradigm. And then in the 20th century by Einsteinian paradigm and also by the quantum mechanical paradigm. There are a number of paradigms within this Chintanya. So there can be a number of paradigms within the Chintanya. What I am going to say is this. All these things, whether it's capitalism, whether it's Western science or Western, not Western music, but the medieval era, but the later of Western music, all these things are combined. You can see that there is some thread that connects all these things. I'll just give an example. Many people think that science has broken away from religion. When I tell you the religion from Christianity, it's not so. It's not so. In cosmology, the branch which I studied for my PhD. It is said that some 13.7 billion years ago, the world or the universe was created spontaneously, the super big bang. And it's also said that this whole universe was concentrated into a very, very small body. All of us have been frustrated in that small body and started flying away from each other. Now there is creation. According to the Bible, the world was created by the God at a certain time. From nothing. Well, you can argue on that, whether it was from nothing or something else. But the essential fact here is that the God created the universe. Now what was there before the God created the universe? Or what was the God doing before he created the universe? I would ask the same question from a scientist or astronomist. What was there before the Big Bang? You know the answer? Answer is that there was no before the Big Bang. Remember? Because time was created. Time was created with the Big Bang. And there was no before time was created. So God created time, and there was no before time was created. So it's not correct to ask the question, what was God doing before the world was created? It's not correct to ask the question, what was there before the world was created? You see that there are parallels. The cosmologists have created their Big Bang within the Jewish paradigm. And I got my PhD for it. I am looking forward to the day I retire so that I can give up my tradition for the simple reason that I know that it does not agree with Buddhism. However much you try to say that it agrees with Buddhism or it be an open mind, no side, I cannot agree with that. All science have been created in a differentiated manner to similar Buddhism. I am using similar Buddhism because we are now the future. That's all. Not because I am the next. And development? What is the development? As I said, we are trying to be an American with bigger cars, faster cars, bigger buildings, air conditioned buildings, wasting energy like this. Simply because we are following them. Now, what is the singular Buddhist development that we can think of? I can give just one brief explanation. Buddhism, ultimately, all the Buddhists try to attain Nirvana. We are all Bodhisattva scavengers. Until that, we want to live, well, I can't express that in English, we want to live, Nivihana Hinde Jivatthi. Now, what is this Nivihana Hinde Jivatthi has to do with Western way of development? Intellectuals or the scientists are rushing from one conference to another conference with hundreds of papers, of course produced with cut and paste technology, rushing from one conference to another conference to establish their grades and also earn points for their promotions. Is that the Nivihana Hinde that we think of? I am afraid it is not. So what are we trying to do? We are trying to patch up our world of science or the world that we live with the Western development and of course with some kind of Buddhism thrown in just for the sake of saying that we are also Buddhist. But I am afraid that these two universities, Jayewardenepura and they were made universities, or rather, they were universities in the 19th century itself. In humanities, they had world records. Now, we have other faculties also. As I said, we were imposed with this Western university structure 50 years ago, and we are celebrating this for some reason or other. Well, I am representing the Ghana University in a sense because I have to give that invitation as well. I have thought of being that invitation as well some 10 years ago. But I have been paid. Now, we had very good humanities of, let's say, need or whatever. But after the university structures were imposed, we we have lost those faculties. Where are those faculties? Professor Chanda Vikramanapi, where are those faculties? What are the distinguished professors there? But where are they now? What happened to these faculties? By trying to compare Buddhism with science, are we trying to reduce even that further to a very, very narrow area? No, I think that's not what we are doing. What we are doing is something else. We are based on the humanities tradition that we have. And we also think of a new internet, new development, new science can be created. I know that. If the Westerners were able to create a new science, just 500 years, they started with Galileo, and within 300 years or 400 years, they were able to do that. And please remember that I cannot touch doing politics here, but none of these is devoid of politics. Even science is as its politics. We all know how much we are affected by this politics, I don't want to do it here. But what I meant is that this knowledge has been created in a different system. And it's time for us to create a science, but another science, yes. Not the science. The science based on, say, Sikharabadi Chintane or Tamil Hindu Chintane or whatever. Now, a leaf has been given in that respect, but I am afraid not to learn this. We have taken certain steps in this direction of the Asian Buddhist area based on Sikharabadism. I am not trying to be a chauvinistic but say Sikharabadism, something wrong with it. The science is coming. Now, that Chintane will create a new science, not only a new science, new development aspect. If you don't believe me, I don't think you believe me, you can read certain books. I'm not trying to recommend any stuff, thinking that you are set apart a religion. No, please. So, just a list of names. I have been interested. Of course there are Westerners. There are some Westerners who are interested in. To begin with, Thomas Kuhn, who came out with his structure of scientific revolution. And only with that, I realized how much lies Popper has been telling. Popper's falsification theory is nothing but false. Falsification is false itself. None of us here go to the lab in order to disprove a theory. I don't think anybody here goes to the lab to disprove a theory. From the day I started my A-level physics, my A-level chemistry, I did not go to the lab to disprove young or Newton's or somebody else. I just went there to show that these people are right. That's all. That's what any ordinary scientist does. Only a very few people come out with different ideas, and with that they sometimes shift the paradigm also. Only a very few people. Only a very few. The others are ordinary scientists who follow the other scientists and try to prove what the other scientists have been saying all this time. Now, that is Thomas Kuhn. Then, a more interesting book was written by a person called Paul Ferrer. He wrote a book under the name Against the Matter, in which he said, and in fact he has shown, that there is no scientific method as such. Unfortunately, I don't have time to elaborate on this. There is no scientific method as such. Popper was trying to say a scientific method, even before that various others were trying to establish that there was scientific method, but there are no, there We are just like everybody else. That is our idea. We just follow certain rules. When people cook, they follow certain rules. Nobody follows scientific rules. Unless somebody goes to scientific cookery class. Ordinary cooking is not called scientific. But I thought you were not making scientific cookery, ordinary cookery, or scientific chemistry, or scientific chemistry. They are all the same. They just follow, well, as a suggestion, I just follow prominent rules. Even cookery and nothing else. Now, that's well up. Then, of course, there are other things. Little bit on this because they have changed my views. And of course then when I started reading Buddhism, I found that what nonsense these people have been talking about this time. And I also realized that with of course another children that this money for children. And we just create certain aspects to it. What I want is not to create stories. We should create stories. But we should start creating stories in our culture. And Kalani and Jyadi are the basic places for us. Not Kalambo, Kalani. Not because both places have attacked me. But because I know that there is no atmosphere or environment for what you do this engagement. So let me conclude my presentation. I agree to a certain extent what the learner's teacher says. But at the same time, I dissociate from them for the simple reason that I have different opinions all today. On what is meant by science, what is meant by development, and of course not what is meant by Buddhism, that is not my thing. All what I say is that there are Buddhisms, and we follow what are the Buddhisms. And I am not going to say that it is the Buddhism or it is the ultimate truth. It is the Buddhism that we have been practicing for the last 2,300 years ago. And also, what I am trying to say is that starting with the Renaissance of Leonardo da Vinci and then coming to Martin Luther and to Galileo and Newton later on, they have created a Chintanaya. And if you want to study this Chintanaya, there is no better book than Weber on Protestant ethic in Calvinism. That is the best book I have read, even though I may not agree with some other. It's the best book I have read on this one, Protestant Ethic on Calvinism. They are, of course, when I read it first time, I didn't realize what I was saying. Now, after so many years, I know that whether he meant or not, what he is saying that would be that Christianity and Calvinism are bound and they go hand in hand. They are like twins. Of course, he doesn't use the word Chintanaya, but I might use the word Chintanaya and say capitalism and Christianity and Western science and all the development that have been taken place during the last 500 years are bound by the Western Christian Jewish Judaic Christian. So it's time for us to go, and also it's time for us to create a new Chintanaya and create a new science. Of course, we have our distinguished people whom we can consult on Buddhism. We have a long tradition, a rich tradition, a rich history. These two places, Vidyodaya, we should build on that tradition. I am not trying for a moment to say that we should reject Western science. No. If you do that, my wife will be without a job. I don't want anyone to do that. What I am trying to say is that we should try to absorb Western sciences as well into our culture. The way that the Westerners did some 300, 400 years ago, we is brave for that. What Newton said or what Galileo said or what Copernicus said was known to the ancient Bharat people. Most of them. What they did was to absorb the knowledge that we had, including what we had in Sri Lanka, into their culture and made it the Western science. Similarly, we should be able to create new in our culture, absorb Western science into our culture, but please, we should not imitate Western science or Western culture. So, I'll conclude my presentation with that. Let's get on to a new era of the 50 years of Western imposed religious instruction. Let's try to get back to the 19th century. When I say let's get back to the 19th century, I am not trying to say that we should go back to our brother. No. That's not what I am trying to say. Let's have our Chaitanya, a solid Chaitanya, and based on that Chaitanya, we'll create a new science and also a new development. Hopefully within the next 10 years. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. De Silva, for a very thought-provoking presentation. We plan to have a discussion for half an hour. I don't think we can go on for so long, but maybe for another 10 or 15 minutes, we can have some questions. Or I would prefer them to be questions rather than comments, and they should be directed at one of the co-panelists. And at the end, I would ask each panelist. I think some panelists may want to respond, especially to what Prof Nalin De Silva has said. So we will give them an opportunity. But if there are questions or directed comments at any of the panelists, I welcome them now. And I'm sure in the discussion we can be flexible even about language. You know, it can be either in English or in English. We have very distinguished. Chandra has left and for the Chandra, we have scientists in the audience, and management professors. Or do you want the four panelists to respond? Yes, Ajit, you would like to say? Yeah, for that study. Yes.
For the
formulator,
so thank you for not a similar I mean, we have now, they are working on the computer. I'm not saying it's absolutely, but it's much more controllable over the material interest and any other kind of model we have. Now, what is wrong? Why is it given wrong that part? Why are we trying to pay part of your business? Why should we give us science to them?
They were of the opinion that the universe expands, but with a piece of it, conduct and expression, the reverse sense of vision. But 10 years ago, in what is known as a supernovae explanation, there is some kind of stars, that they discovered, by studying supernovae, they discovered that the universe is accelerating. Now, until now, no Westerner has come out with a very good theory to explain how the universe, because he is already all this time, has become accelerating or whatever sudden. However, they have come up with, whenever they don't know anything, they use words like dark energy. It's due, they say it's due to dark energy. They never say it's due to white energy. It's always dark energy. They are culture-based concepts, right? So dark is, it's supposed to be dark energy. Now, of course, we also look into this, haven't we? And of course, I must say that I am biased. I don't have an open mind. I am biased because I have, my mind is tuned to singular Buddhism. I am not scared to say that. Now, I have read about Akali Sutra. Akali Sutra describes the samvarta kappa and vivarta kappa, that is the universe which is expanding and also contracting. Not only just expanding. So now, of course, I am still in the middle, in the sense it's a hybrid sort of situation. So I took Einstein's theory, not me, and my students did all these things. They did Einstein's theory. And there is something called the cosmological constant. We make that constant variable. That is not taking it as a constant. We put it to be a function of time. It varies with time. Then we found that this acceleration can be explained with that. Not only that, it's very funny. Funny in this sense, when we found, when we worked out the models, of course, now for 2 or 3 years we could not explain some other aspect of the universe because, according to the Western scientists, these observations, early universe had an inflation, not the inflation that the economists think of, but the very rapid acceleration at the very beginning. Now, just about 3 weeks ago, we were able to explain even that extreme, that rapid expansion, super inflation with this. And we find that the universe, we have that right, that universe starts from, say, not from zero, but from radius, and then expand with an acceleration. Rapid acceleration, then decelerate, then accelerate again, and then there's the reverse process. And it will go on repeating itself in cycles. And suppose I am being very close by the single piece, depending on someone to cover, anyone to cover. Not the Big Bang. Big Bang is creation for once and for all creation. It was created some 13.7 billion years ago. Now, our water is not just expansion starting from a single point. It expands, then it contracts, then it expands again. It's the organization concept that we are making. Now, that's what I am saying that, well, of course, I claim that my idea is better than the Western theory. Of course, nobody else agrees with me. That's a different story. But we can show that our universe, our universe being the universe that we have created, works better than the universe that Western scientists have created. So when you ask me the question, why was there about something else when it's working well? One, it's not working well. Two, there may be better theories that you can come up with using conception of the cultures. am using this for simple reason that I am debating this one, but there may be other concepts in other countries.
Explanation about Buddha speaking, you can find it in internet.
So we can use those things properly. Again, Jewish, Buddhist, or in Buddhism, Buddhism is Buddha's teaching no race, no caste, no any belong to anyone. It is universal truth belong to everybody. Even Buddhist scholars like Bhikkhu Bodhi, he's the person who wrote so many translated many Pali canon to English. Bhikkhu Nyanapolika, he's the person translated the Irish by birth. But now they are real Buddhist monks. Actually, Nyanapolika passed away. Bhikkhu Bodhi still lives in America. Thank you.
To ask a question or comment about this discussion.
Constructing new theories based on them, or writing to go back to some kind of Buddhism that was supposed to have been taught by Buddha. One might say, well, that's fundamentalism. I'm not really happy about that further, but I don't really do any argument here. So, yeah, my respect very much. And so I just divide that.
All of you are thinking with what means to the great me that we have had a real intellectual trip. I must say I realized how little I know. But I realized it in a very stimulating manner, and it has really opened my thoughts very much. And I intend to learn more about the aspects that all four speakers have spoken about. I would like the audience to display their appreciation of the speaker's contribution in the usual manner. Once again, thank you very much on behalf of the organizing committee. I think you have more than lived up to the expectations we had when we planned this seminar. I would like to ask the people, I think we have planned our subsequent sessions also in the same manner, and you will get a mix of disciplines and mix of ideas and philosophies at a very high level. So I request you, especially the academic staff, to convey this message to your friends, and even if they have not registered for this session, as you can see, we have catered for 500 people, including the refreshments and lunch. You could tell them to come, and please make use of this real, it's not the food that I'm talking about, the intellectual treat that we have arranged for it. Please convey the message and try to ensure even greater participation tomorrow. Thank you very much. I think that brings the events of the day to the close. I hand over to Sepal.
Yes, our sincere thanks goes to Professor Nalin De Silva, former Vice Chancellor of the University of Jayewardenepura, for chairing the session and also the speakers who did the presentations. Now I would like to invite Dr. Indile Karunaratne, Vice Chancellor of the University of Jayewardenepura, to come on stage and present the tokens of appreciation to the presenters of the theme seminar. Will be presented to Venerable Dr. Valpalapiyan Andathero by the Vice Chancellor. The next token of appreciation will be presented to Mr. W. Jayewardene. Thank you and good night.